everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. In today's game, we've got two corners who hope they can have an opportunity to shine on defense. It's Sherman's Seahawks going up against Peterson's Cardinals. So let's send you out to the Valley of the Sun as we welcome in our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. It hosted Super Bowls 42 and 49. And it's University of Phoenix Stadium. That's where we're at in Glendale, Arizona. Tonight, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Seattle Seahawks and the Arizona Cardinals. And a welcome in, everybody, with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, and Charles, so much gets made about offensive comparisons. Here's a matchup where the defenses may just take center stage.
Yeah, we're usually talking about guys scoring touchdowns. How about the guys who prevent them and change the momentum of the game when they take the ball away? I love those ball hawks in the secondary. People after my own heart.
Here's Chandler Catanzaro ready to get this one started. Charles and I have been looking forward to this one all week. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Trotting onto the field, the 27-year-old Russell Wilson. He'll be in charge for the Seattle Seahawks, and Wilson in the win over the Falcons week 6, 270 yards, no touchdowns, also no picks.
And sometimes that's what it takes to manage a game and win one. And I know a lot of people are used to Russell Wilson also having an effect on a game with his legs, but he's had those injuries in the early going. He's protecting himself right now. When he gets healthy, we'll see that added back into his repertoire.
Fourth-year man from Texas A&M, Christian Michael. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9. And this offense often hinges on one of the best tight ends in the league, and that's Jimmy Graham.
I think he made up for lost time when he got to the NFL because in college he was mainly a basketball player, a defender who couldn't score. Now he's flipped it around in the NFL. Every time he touches the ball, he's a threat to score.
Again with Michael, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Back-to-back 1-yard runs here, so that leaves him with a 3rd down and 8. And the 11 defensive starters for Arizona.
Patrick Peterson is almost an anomaly at cornerback. A big, thick, physical guy who can run with any receiver in the league.
An early tough test on the opening drive. This is 3rd and 8. On 3rd down, Wilson. And he finds Jimmy Graham. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. And good to see Jimmy back out there moving okay after the ruptured patella in week 12 last year. You've dealt with that injury, haven't you?
I have, and let me tell you know that expression, I feel your pain? I felt Jimmy's when it happened. Now, mine didn't happen quite the same way his did. His happened in the line of duty. He was playing in a game. For me, I was just coaching. And went up to try and catch a pass. Poof. I think for me, it was just mainly age. For him, he was actually playing.
But good to see him back out there healthy. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be brought down at about the 33-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it 2nd and a foot or so. For Christian Michael, his 5th year in the league. First 4 years, a total of 497 yards. But now getting a chance in Seattle, 354 through 6 weeks.
I love what he said about the whole thing, about how he had to wake up and realize what he needed to do in his career. And he rededicated himself this year with a second opportunity in Seattle. And boy, it's paying off, not just for him, but for the Seahawks.
And he added 2 scores to go along with 64 yards in their game against the Falcons in week 6. Only a gain of a yard there, but it indeed gets him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to wind up and air it out. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
When teams take shots at the end zone, you've got to defend it the same way you would defend the first down sticks. You defend the goal line exactly the same way. They can't cross that. You play through the receivers. And on that play, that's exactly what they did and batted it away.
And on second and 10 now. Second and 10 now, Wilson. Able to get away.
That's why you keep the legs churning.
It's an 8-yard pickup, and just like that, it's third down. It's been a 7-play opening drive, and this is third and short. On the run, this is Michael. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
Well, on that play, the expression, don't blink, you might miss something, certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
So Wilson will head to the sideline, and on comes Steven Hauschka for the field goal. From the left hash mark, this a 43-yard attempt. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. It's picked up. A live ball here, remember.
So the next time we leave one of those coaches' meetings and we're walking out in the hall and you're like, how come we spend so much time talking about special teams?
Here you go. This is why.
This is why, right? And then look, I'm right there with you. We hear it every time we meet with coaches, but it is a big part of it. And look at how early in the game this occurs. They block a kick, and not only does it set a tone, it sends a message for the rest of the game.
Yeah, so much for our first points of the game. First down and incomplete to open things up. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Second and 10, it's Palmer again. Over the middle, Jerron Brown's got it. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play. But what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
Yeah, I think the blitz there really disrupted the draw.
Yeah, and it's usually when you catch them in a blitz, the draw works pretty well. If you're the offensive coordinator right now, that's visor throwing time, isn't it? Because that's supposed to work in a big way.
So on fourth down, here's Ryan Quigley now to kick this one away. Back deep for the Seahawks, the All-Pro returner from 2015, Tyler Lockett. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
They'll run it here with Michael. And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this 2nd down call after that type of a game.
So the offense readies for a 2nd and 4. On 2nd down, Wilson. And the grab made by Doug Baldwin. And he's brought down. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
I don't care how many times you tell the story, it never loses its luster for me. Doug Baldwin, undrafted out of Stanford, and plays like a number 1 receiver should in the NFL. I don't care how you cover him. I don't care that his size isn't great. He's the one that typically comes up with the football.
Absolutely. His roots go all the way back to Gulf Breeze, Florida, where he's from, right on the water near Pensacola, and then, of course, to Stanford, and boy, he's been good. They come out here in the eye. On the ground, it's Michael. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Now we're going to get a stoppage here as we've got an injured Cardinal on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. So here we go, 1st and 10 now. On 1st and 10, it's Wilson. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be 2nd and very short.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Look pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
And that's a nice pickup of a 1st down on that 2nd down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the 1st on the ground. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
So we've got a 2nd and 5. Now Wilson on 2nd down. This complete to Lockett. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
This offense is in rhythm now, just accumulating first downs and moving the ball downfield.
And the offense lining up first and 10. They come out here in the eye. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. He's got time. Complete out right to Kurz. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the first here on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll get him down right around the 16. And they're still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. 7 yards on the pickup there, and now they've got it first and goal.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
And this seemingly endless drive continues. From the shotgun, Wilson. That's complete right around the 8. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the 1. They'll give him 8 on the play.
Well, partner, Jimmy is no longer down. Jimmy Graham is back and in a big way. How about this past week? Another excellent game, and I believe he's averaging over 100 yards per game in his last 3 outings.
He is indeed, and you're right. 6 catches, 89 yards in week 6. He's back. So an even first quarter on the scoreboard, but the threat of points on the horizon. Nothing, nothing, our score. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Alongside my broadcast partner, Charles Davis, Brandon Gaughton hits the Seahawks with a football to begin quarter number 2, and they'll come up looking to keep this drive moving. And a really long drive here, and it goes on and on. Second and goal from the 1. On the carry, Michael. And he will take this one in for the Seattle touchdown. Christian Michael taking it in. And the Seahawks have taken the lead. And he was excellent on that drive. He deserved to be the one to get across the chalk.
Oh, I agree with you totally. A workhorse on the drive. And how about that last decisive run to punch it in?
Steven Hauschka for the point after. And this will give the Seahawks a 7-0 lead. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. And our attention shifts here to the Seahawks defense. They were able to force the 3-and-out last time, led to the punt, and then led to a touchdown for their crew. So they'll be looking for a little bit more of that, Charles.
Well, I think that they created the spark with the 3-and-out. Gave a little momentum to their offense. They said, all right, appreciate it, guys. And they took the ball downfield and stuck it in the end zone.
And that defense wasn't out there long. They'll be trying to keep it short here. They begin the drive with Johnson. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2.
Have you talked with your friends who are in the fantasy leagues? I keep hearing David Johnson's name is coming up in a big way.
Boy, he was a steal third-rounder out of Northern Iowa, and I think last year started as a fourth-string back, didn't he?
He certainly did, but boy, he produces the year one on. Remember, can run it. He can catch it. He was a wide receiver at Northern Iowa before he became a running back and also has great kick return ability. Ran one back for a touchdown in 2015.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
Not too many more ideal situations at 2nd and 2 in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. They come out here in the eye. A first down carry here for Johnson. And he'll get this across the 40 and up to about the 42-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Now they'll throw it with Palmer. Screenplay, Johnson. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
So the offense has it 1st and 10. His first carry, and he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2, and that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8, now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Again, they run with Ellington. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. He lost 2 there, and it's 3rd down.
partner into the second quarter, and I guess you can kind of look at it both ways. The offense, they've got to figure out what they're going to do because they haven't scored any points. But if you're the defense, you're feeling great about what you've got going on. The only concern you have, if you get to the half, what adjustments will the offense make to try to defeat you?
Hey, tight end's right. Watch tight end.
Third and 11, five in the secondary now.
Nickel look. From midfield now, here's Palmer. He gets it to Brown. Good play. John Brown. Touchdown, Cardinals. John Brown, 50 yards. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
And how about the phases of a successful catch and a completion of a play? Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then, of course, the run after the catch that ends up in the end zone.
Here's Chandler Catanzaro for the extra point. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Tyler Lockett now with a return. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. They come out here in the eye. Here's Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. No gain, and it's second down.
And that's when it's fun to play defense. When you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football, and spill the play, that's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
Right. 10 yards still left on second down. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
On third down, Wilson. Underneath to Spiller. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
On first down, Wilson. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
On second down, it's caught on the left side by Baldwin. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be taken down at the 34. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense. Hold him to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only one on that play.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. They'll run it now out of the gun. And not much running room. Down to the 32. Give him 3 yards, and now they're left needing a conversion here on 3rd and 6.
Partner, we know today's NFL is really built around the guy throwing the football. But these short runs, they still pay dividends because they can take their toll on a defense, and they can add up as the game goes along. You control the clock, you control the ball, and that way you often control the game.
From the gun on 3rd down, Wilson finding time. This complete to Lockett. Look at the spin.
Balance.
And that little deke, the juke move that we saw, able to give him the first down yardage before he's brought down. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. More from the desert after this. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. On 1st down. And this is intercepted, but they'll say out of bounds. So very close to a turnover there in the end zone.
And that's why defenders are often frustrated offensive guys. Actually made the catch, looked good doing it, but couldn't get his feet down in order to finish off the takeaway.
Slotted out to the left. Again on 2nd and 10, it's Wilson. That's going to be caught at the 10-yard line. It's a gain of 7, and all of a sudden here, it's 3rd down.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
To throw again is Wilson. And he's got the big tight end, Graham. Touchdown, Seattle. Jimmy Graham from 4 yards out. And the Seahawks are able to strike for six.
And that touchdown gives them a touchdown lead before they attempt the extra point. What a great way to end the half.
Yeah, great job to put themselves in front. And now see on the sideline, special teams defense scrambling, saying we want to preserve this for the final moments of this second quarter. Here's Hauschka for the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
On first and 10, it's Palmer. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away, incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Well, incomplete there, but Charles, switching gears for a second, talking about quarterback play. We have seen a lot of good quarterback play so far this year, haven't we?
We always talk about Drew Brees. That's almost old hat, but let's give him his respect. But how about some new names that are on this list? Matt Ryan has elevated his game to its highest level. How about what Sam Bradford has done in Minnesota? Did anyone really see that coming? And the rookie, Dak Prescott, he deserves big-time mention for the start he's given Dallas.
And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion.
Let's go.
On third down, Johnson. And they will stop. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play. Here's Ryan Quigley now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And it'll be Seahawk football as they take over deep in their own territory. Here's Russell Wilson and the Seahawk offense now getting set to go again. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes, but right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll power his way up near the 25. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves him with a second and three.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
Three yards remaining here on second down. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we send you on to Orlando, we hook back up with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. Both teams have played a clean first half and that there are no turnovers to this point. That being the case, it's no surprise that we have a very close game at halftime. All right, let's roll the highlights. Now third and eight, Wilson's going to complete the pass, and he won't be brought down until he makes it to the 43-yard line. But they failed to come away with points on the drive. Now it's early in the second. Michael's going to take off here, and he'll go in for a score. Seahawks up by a touchdown. Third and long, quick pass is complete, and this play goes for a score. Cardinals tied up at seven. Seahawks have it late in the second. Wilson's going to complete the pass from the gun, and he caps the drive with a score. That puts them up by a touchdown.
Thank you, LR. Appreciate it. A one-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. J.J. Nelson now to return. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. And time now for the Seahawk defense to take their spots again on the field. They look good in the first half. They'll be looking to carry that momentum over into half number two.
Finish a game the way you started it. That's typically the message at halftime when things are going well. You've done everything you're expected to do. How about a little bit more of that in the second half? But be aware, they may throw something different at you to begin things.
Yeah, 50% of the equation still left to go. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Hey, four down, four down. Let's go, let's go. Blue 58.
And they start the second half with Johnson. And he'll push his way forward to about the 32. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
No, that wasn't an explosive run. That wasn't one that took it all the way to the house. But, boy, for a team that's had trouble running it the entire game, that's the kind of run they need, hopefully, to get themselves kick-started.
Johnson, and this carry not as productive. He's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time, but you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
All right, now, one, eight, ten.
From the gun on third down, it's Palmer. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped. Altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down.
Anytime a ball's thrown in the middle of the field and it's popped up in the air, I expect someone to catch. It doesn't matter whether it's offense or defense, because there's usually a great amount of bodies in that part of the field. In this case, no one came up with it.
To stop it. Hits at the 8, but it carries all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away.
Yeah,
defense,
we got the lead.
Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see what the offense gets done.
The tackle there by Patrick Peterson.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, and you throw it again. Then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set them up.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
9 yards to go. It's 3rd down. On 3rd down, Wilson. Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Kevin Minter, he's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of 5, and it'll bring up 4th down.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
Here's John Ryan now, standing just outside his own goal line. Ellington now to return it.
Whoosh.
Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Cards will take over 1st and 10. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Get ready! Blue 58! Blue 58!
They'll try to get the offense going with Johnson. No gain on the play. It'll be 2nd down. Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
Get ready! Seaver!
They go to Johnson again. And good penetration here. He'll get this down only to about the 49-yard line. Just a couple there on the 2nd down run. Now they're staring at a 3rd-and-8 situation.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
On 3rd down, Palmer. And this is going to be incomplete. The tight end, Jermaine Gresham, the intended receiver. Now 4th down. Here's Ryan Quigley now. He's been terrific so far. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. The Cardinal defense, they head out to get set here. Their stay on the field last time was short-lived with a 3-and-out. See if they can get some more of that.
And ordinarily, you want to be on the field playing, right? But 3-and-out, that's almost gold to a defense. Get to the bench, get some rest, turn the ball over to your offense.
We'll see what they can do here. See if they can force another 3-and-out. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8. And third quarter here, you've got the lead. This is where that strong run game can really benefit you. Stayed in bounds there, kept the clock going.
I like all the points you just made there. And if you throw the football and it's incomplete, now you've stopped the clock and you've helped out the guys on the other side of the ball. So keep it in the hands of those runners. Keep moving it. Keep grinding clock.
Now Wilson, his throw incomplete. Tyler Lockett was the target there. Third down here. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. They go play action with Wilson. He finds his man, Baldwin. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35.
I don't care how many times we see it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
They come out here in the eye. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it 2nd down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Watch tight end. Watch tight end. Tight end's right. Tight end's right. Check.
On 2nd down, Wilson. Baldwin with it over the middle. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Now Wilson on 2nd down. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's 3rd. Seventh play of the drive upcoming here on 3rd and 6. From the gun on 3rd down, Wilson. And that is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jermaine Kearse, and it brings up 4th down. Here's John Ryan now. as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this one hits at the one, continues on into the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Ground with Johnson, and the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line, making the stop that time, Bobby Wagner.
When the 4-3 defense is functioning really well, you know who stays what we call clean and no one gets to him? The guy playing the middle linebacker position, the guy we call Mike. That means the defensive front is eating up all the blocks and just let him go to the football and make a play.
Now Palmer to throw on second down. Over the middle, and it's incomplete. And if they want to keep this drive alive, they'll need 8 yards here on third down. From the gun on third down, it's Palmer surveying the field. It's brought in by Floyd, and he gets it to the 34, good enough for the first. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes the play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
He gets it into the hands of Larry Fitzgerald. It's a gain of 14 there, and it'll give the Cardinals a first down.
I know that throughout his career, Carson Palmer has caught a little bit of grief along the way about winning big games and being consistent. But I've noticed that when he doesn't connect with Larry Fitzgerald until the second half, their team's behind.
Absolutely, not a good recipe. And we were wondering, we said at halftime, they've got to get on the same page.
He is very important to his team. I would say vital. Carson Palmer finding Larry Fitzgerald, that's the winning edge for them.
Palmer gives to Johnson, and able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
We got four. We got four. Here we go. Blue 95.
On second down, Palmer. And this one complete to Jermaine Gresham. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. 8 yards on the pick up there, and it moves the sticks. We have played three quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back to the desert. We're in Glendale. It's Cardinal football, but they trail here as we get set to bring you the fourth and final quarter. Fresh set of downs here.
Get ready. Blue 58.
They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. And this one is incomplete.
Pass interference. Defense.
Pass interference call. Charles, you were a defender. You know how hard it is to defend the pass without committing this penalty.
And if they would let them play with a little bit more contact to give the defender a better chance, we wouldn't have nearly as many flags.
And now a first down following that long game. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Following the penalty, it's Johnson. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Right now, wide 18.
On second down, here's Palmer. That is caught at the 7-yard line. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 and the 6.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
The 8th play of the drive coming up. It's 3rd and 3.
Get ready. Blue 58.
Palmer now to throw on 3rd down. That's caught at the 3. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the 1st down as he's tackled at the 2. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line giving them time to complete that 1st down pass.
Time in the pocket. All kinds of time. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Well, any caused incompletion is good for a defense, but when you add to it, you get a little hit on the quarterback, knock him to the ground, make him think a little bit, hopefully knock him off his game, especially in a game of this magnitude, this tight in the 4th quarter, gotta feel pretty good as a defense.
They come out here in the eye. They'll run it with Johnson. And he is in for 6. Touchdown, Cardinals. David Johnson taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Cardinals are just an extra point away from tying this game.
Well, Brandon, he just followed his nose, and his nose took him to the end zone. But how about the big guys up front giving him at least a stalemate in order to find that space?
Yeah, the O-line won the battle in the trenches there, didn't they? And now a critical extra point attempt here. And we are tied here in the 4th quarter. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this 4th quarter. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And they'll be looking to avoid what happened last time, which is punting the football.
But when you look at how teams play the game, that complementary football comes into play. How do I take care of my defense? How do I take care of my offense? Well, the defense is taking care of them in a lot of ways. Now it's time for the offense to jump things up and help their defense out. Give them a little bit of rest.
Yeah, time for them to give them a rest. She took the words right out of my mouth.
Check three, check three.
first and 10. It's Wilson. He's got time. It's caught on the left side by Kurz. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 17 that time. And it'll give the Seahawks a first down. Simple slant route, and part of a really nice hard throw by the quarterback.
Nice timing between the quarterback and the receiver. They were perfectly in sync, and he put it right on him on the inside route.
Start there. That will set the offense back 5 yards.
Brandon, the lineman, certainly flinched there before the snap. A good call.
Still first down.
Wilson. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
You know the key to a good screen pass is, don't you?
Bet you're going to tell me. Good blocking?
Well, good blocking eventually. But first is good acting. You want to let the defenders go past you, leak out to whichever side or even in the middle where you want to set up the screen, and then you do your blocking. How about the read, though, by the defensive guys? They weren't fooled at all and actually ran with the lineman to where the play was and smothered it for a loss of yardage.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. And they only get a yard back there. They'll be left with a third down and long. DB added here for the Cards on third.
Blitzer play coverage.
Here's Wilson. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. Here's John Ryan now as he's on to punt for Seattle. And he didn't quite have the backspin on that one. It hits at the 4 and continues into the end zone. It's a touchback. And the Seahawks defense heads back out there now. Last drive, touchdown surrendered. Here, see if they can stop him.
It's always a constant battle of letting the last series go, good or bad, but especially bad. Give up a touchdown. Okay, forget the finger pointing, forget the blame. Go back out and play the defense you know you're capable of and help your team out.
And probably look to the leaders, as always.
As always. They're going to be the ones going to grab some people and say, all right, let's do this thing.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. And Palmer gives to Johnson. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one, and it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
See if they stay on the ground for second down. Now Palmer to throw on second down. Toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. Still 9 yards to go on third down. One receiver right, that's Brown. On third down, Palmer. Finding time. And he's got Gresham. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Let's go, let's go. 1-18.
They pitch it out to Johnson. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. That's going to go as a loss of 6, and it'll set him back for second down.
Whenever I go to a team's practice facility and watch them work, I love to watch the defensive guys in what they call pursuit drills. The ball goes either towards them or away from them. How fast will they respond? On this play, the defensive end responded better than anyone and made a really nice play.
It's a 5-receiver set, 3 to the left, 2 to the right. On second down, Palmer. And Gresham's got it over the middle. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. It'll be a gain of 8 yards, and they're going to face a third down.
Completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
A nickel look by Seattle on third down.
Yep, 5 defensive backs now. Now it's Palmer surveying the field. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
You know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Here's Ryan Quigley now as he'll come on for his 5th kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Fair catch called for and collected right at the 10-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And possession will switch here as this offense will come on deep in their own territory. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away, and they're set to go on the field as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we've got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
Give them a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
They come up in an offset eye. On 2nd down, Wilson. This complete to Lockett. And able to get this one out just shy of the 25 at the 24.
Now that was pretty. They executed that curl route versus zone coverage, and that changes things a little bit because against man, it's often a tight curl, tight, sharply run route. Against zone, you're just looking for that open spot, that dead area, so you may curl it a little bit wider just to get to that place.
And usually a tight window. He fired a bullet in there for the completion. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. And he just gets rid of it, throws it away. The wise move there, looked like nobody open. Now 2nd down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. Second and 10, it's Wilson again. He's got time in the pocket. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Kevin Minter. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line. So how about that for a momentum switch?
We're in the 4th quarter and it's a tie game. You've got to take care of the football here.
Now their opportunity to take the lead right out the window, and everything is flipped in the other direction.
The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. And a great spot to start this drive from here.
Hey, four down. Get ready! Blue 58!
So after the interception, here's Palmer. Backing up. Great protection. He's going to let this one go deep. And this is caught! And he'll take this one in for the Arizona touchdown. Larry Fitzgerald, 33 yards. And the Cardinals turning that interception into a touchdown.
Did you see them hold up four fingers at the start of the fourth quarter?
They were ready.
They were definitely ready. They may or may not have done that, but they certainly have played that way. The fourth quarter has belonged to them, and now the lead belongs to them as well.
Point after now from Catanzaro. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14. Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. This fielded at the two. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. The grab made by Kearse over the middle. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Second down now after the pass completion. In the slot on the right is Graham. On second down, here's Wilson. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. And a nice gain of 21 yards. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
To throw. And some space here. And he'll slide down to avoid the contact. Give him 8 on the play, and that'll make it a 2nd down. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Back to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive. He's back to throw. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's brought down. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. And now they're in the hurry up. Back to throw. He's got time. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. Second down here after the incomplete pass. He'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And oh, not only did he drop it, he dropped it in the end zone.
You can feel the anguish all the way up here. It certainly looked like he had that one in the end zone, open, unable to hold on to it.
Comes the 7th play now of this drive as this is 3rd and 10. Throwing now is Wilson. Completes it to Lawler. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Kenny Lawler in the final minute. And the Seahawks just an extra point away from tying this thing up.
And while it appears the heavy lifting was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down 1. That extra point is not a gimme.
And now a critical extra point attempt here. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the 4th. Set to go now with the kickoff. These two teams all even again as we continue in this wild 4th quarter. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. So out now come the Cardinals. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. They get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call another play. But if they don't, it's hurry up to the line of scrimmage and either spike it and stop the clock or continue to move it downfield in order to try and get in range and win this game.
See if they can do just that.
Here we go, blue 58.
Now it's Palmer. Dumping it off for Johnson. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages.
Check,
Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Here's Palmer. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So we're back in the offense getting set following the call of that timeout. So they're behind the chains as the offense. 12 yards needed on third down.
Get ready. 1, 18.
The busy night continues for Johnson. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down. And now the Seahawks are going to take a timeout here on defense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. So a defensive timeout, chance to regather, regroup, and get set as we resume action. Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he'll come on to kick for a sixth time tonight. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Now it's Lockett. Look at the spin.
Balance.
A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And possession will change here with very little time remaining in this contest. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. They can still get into field goal range, partner. They got to work quickly, though.
I agree with you totally. Find a way to get the ball downfield and out of bounds. In a perfect world, they know what hash they want to get to for their kicker, and they already know the distance that he feels comfortable. That'll dictate what they do on offense.
See if they can get in his range. There's Wilson. Finding time. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete. Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Now Wilson, surveying the field. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
My high school coach John Ford used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me.
Wilson to throw. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. So we saw a lot of points in quarters 1, 2, 3, and 4. Overtime comes. The defenses, they clamp down.
Rather amazing, isn't it? Because would you have even thought that we'd get to overtime after what we witnessed for 4 quarters?
Not at all.
And have 0 points on either side? Not a chance, right? And somehow it happened. We always talk about making adjustments. Maybe both defenses took 4 full quarters in order to get an adjustment. Got 1 good period in for both defenses, and now they go home. You buying tonight?
I thought it was you. I did last week. I did the last 2 weeks.
Oh, I was trying to go
dinner,
for three.
Dinner on you, my good
trying
man.
Trying to go for three.
Nothing between these two teams for four quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And last year that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. They're set for their first drive here in overtime. And this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
And it's been loud in here so far. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Not a big run on the first play of the drive, but that doesn't necessarily mean it was a bad play. Sometimes you're just trying to settle in, get your guys a little bit of contact, and get things moving.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on 2nd down. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he powers his way up past the 30. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to 3rd down.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick, he's been decisive, and he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
3 yards left to grab here on 3rd down. First throw in overtime now for Wilson. And he locates Luke Wilson. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
And that catch there by Luke Wilson goes for a first down, and he's really developed and come on. Now, remember, Jimmy Graham, who was expected to be the key tight end for Russell Wilson, he was hurt most of 2015. Luke Wilson really jumped his game up.
So here we go, 1st and 10 now. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. A gain of 3, 2nd down. Seven yards to go on 2nd down. They go play fake to Michael. Now Wilson. The grab made by Curse over the middle. A good pickup there of 22. Well, we haven't been shortchanged on offense. Another fun play to watch there on the deep pass.
This game has the feel of, what, a turkey bowl, a Thanksgiving day. You know, when we get together this year, when the Davises and the Gaudens get together, that's what our playbook's going to look like they're drawing them up in the dirt. And so far, it's working for both of them.
And the offense lining up 1st and 10. Now Wilson on 1st down. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And he is going to lose yardage here. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. Well, they try to swing it out left into the flat. Complete, but really nice open field tackling.
And they played that one like a great boxer. They were on their toes on that one. They weren't back on their heels reacting to the play. No, they saw it, came right for it, and made a nice tackle for lost yardage.
Defense in a good spot. Let's see how the offense responds with a 2nd and 13 now. On 2nd down, here's Wilson. On the screen, complete to Spiller. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there, because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. On 3rd down, Wilson. He's got time in the pocket. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. It'll be a gain of 6, and that's going to make it 4th down. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. This to at least get them a lead here in overtime. And Hauschka's kick is good. And that will break our tie and give them a 3-point lead. All right, so they're able to put 3 on the board here on the opening drive of OT, and now it'll be up to their defense to try and see this one out.
So remember now, a field goal on this next drive would get us to sudden death. Any kind of turnover or turnover on downs would end the game, as would any touchdown. So this one's still very much up in the air.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. Now it's Allington to return. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. The field goal would push it to sudden death. We just saw the field goal on the other end, but I don't think they are thinking field goal. At least not to start this drive, they're not thinking field goal.
Not at all, because your point is well taken. Yeah, kick the field goal, you push it to sudden death, but you're also kicking off and giving the other team the ball with a chance to kick a field goal and beat you. Get the touchdown, finish the game off. That has to be the mindset.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. First throw in overtime now for Palmer. Dumping it off for Johnson. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Three receivers to the left, one to the right. On first down, it's Palmer. Over the middle here to Brown. And he's brought down after a good game. It's a gain of 24 that time. And that'll be good for an Arizona first down. So the offense has it first and 10. They'll throw on first down here with Palmer. Caught on the left side, Fitzgerald. And he's brought down. They give him 15 more, and it's another first down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. They'll put 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. Throwing now, Palmer on first down. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Second down following the incompletion.
Hey, four down. Here we go. Blue, 95.
Second and 10. It's Palmer again. Completes it over the middle to Floyd. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. That one good for 10 yards. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
It's a nice completion, a little bit of run after catch as well to create the yardage that they got. But it is so tough to cover that route, the drag route, because they run it at varying speeds, because the key is to create hesitancy on the defender's part.
Always so empathetic for those DBs, aren't you? And we've got movement by one of the big boys up front for Arizona. Flag comes in.
False start, offense. Still third down.
And the yellow flag hurts this offense, and now they face a tough third down. They come out here in the eye. Again, it's Palmer. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
So now Catanzaro comes on in a pressure spot. And now the Seahawks are going to call another timeout. They'll be down to just one remaining as we step aside here in overtime. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. So here we go. Maybe the biggest kick of the game forthcoming. This to keep the game alive. And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And we are tied once again here in the overtime session. Well, this one certainly has not lacked for intrigue. What do you say we keep on playing, partner?
Well, it's okay by me, Brandon. That is yet another pressure field goal right there. Each guy's made one here in this overtime. And from here on out, it'll be the next score that wins.
Points be enough to do it? We'll soon know as we continue here in overtime. Fielded about a yard deep. Trucks throw him.
Oh, man, right through him.
And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Here's the Cardinals defense as they head out to set up shop. And a field goal surrendered the last time out. Just by and large, are field goals wins for the defensive side?
They certainly are in today's football because offenses are so tuned up and usually have the ability to strike almost at will that when you're only giving up three, you feel like it's almost like basketball. You're trading, right? I give up three on my end. I'm counting my offense to get six on the other, and that is a win.
Yeah, it's a win for the kicker, too, I guess, if he makes the field goal, right?
No doubt about it. He feels good about things, but his team feels like they settled.
They come out here in the eye. Now a play fake here on first down. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. The grab made by Curse over the middle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Give them 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Now we've got whistles and movement up front. I think this is against Seattle.
False start, offense. Still first down.
Give this time to the tailback. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time. 14 yards there on the pickup, and that'll make it second and short.
That's a good strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
2 minutes to go here in overtime. We'll be back after this. Second and very short here, less than a yard. They'll run the option left. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42.
To me, that's a superior play by the backer because he was allowed to, I think, run free on it and make that play. His defensive linemen, they covered things down for him because offensive guys, the linemen, what they're trying to do, as you know, is block the guy at the point of attack and then climb to the next level and get the linebacker. When you're not allowed to climb, you got a free hitter, and that's what we saw there, and a really nice play resulted for them.
On third down, Wilson. And Graham's got it over the middle. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. And he'll give it here to his running back. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they're going to just roam and hit.
Now it's Wilson. Oh, and it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. So we will see yet another drive in this overtime.
For whatever reason, neither team able to finish this game off. I know that the first thought is, does anyone really want to win it? But I think that they both desperately want to win it, and sometimes you force things, and that leads to errors.
Well, it's out there for the taking. We'll see who can do it. The Seattle defense getting set to go. And 3 points surrendered on the last drive against them. They bent a little bit, but they didn't break.
I like that, and that's not always wrong. We run into a lot of coordinators that talk about, well, if I give up 3 points, my whole day is ruined. Actually, it's not. Just giving up field goals usually gives your team a chance to win if you're playing good defense.
Yeah, especially in the National Football League. After the interception, here's Palmer. Over the middle here to Brown. And he had a nifty little deep juke move, but he stopped shortly thereafter. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. Second down, and the offense in search of 6 yards. They'll put two receivers left, two to the right. On second down, here's Palmer. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Defense thinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on third and six. Rush coming, and he's taken down. The two-time Pro Bowler, Bobby Wagner, in there to drop him for a loss of 10. And it'll be fourth and long. Well, how about this? The very, very rare tie that we just witnessed. Hard to believe.
You don't see it very often. A bonus period of football, yet both teams go home a little bit unsatisfied.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com.